Good morning students, today we are ready to going to solve few problems based on heating effect of currents. Before heating effect of current solving problems, just once we can recall about power concepts in current electricity. So how we can define power? Power is nothing but rate of work done, we people know. Means one thing I am representing here, power is represented with P. P is equal to, we can able to write as work done W divided by time, we may represent it. So we have the basic formula for power is P is equal to work done divided by time. This is the basic formula for us. See students, once recall electric potential concept. So from electric potential we know one thing, that is nothing but V is equal to W by Q. Therefore how much value for work done here? W is equal to V into Q. So let, I am substituting this W value in power notation. Therefore power is equal to, we can represent as V into Q divided by T. See students, this is very very important point here. In a starting class in a current electricity we are recalled one thing, that is nothing but Q by T is nothing but electric current, that is represented with I. So P is equal to, we have one fundamental formula, that is V into I, this one. See students, this P is represented in two different notations also. So first notation I am representing, first initially P is equal to V into I, one notation I am represented. So from this one P is equal to, here instead of V I am writing here I R by Ohm's law into I. So therefore P is equal to, I got here as I square R, one notation we got it. Similar manner, one more notation also we can able to find. Here P is equal to VI, we know very well. So P is equal to, I am writing V as it is, I am representing. Instead of I am representing V by R by Ohm's law only. So then P value is equal to V square by R, one notation we are identified. See students, here P is equal to, overall we have three formulas, that is P is equal to VI one formula, another one is I square R, and one more is V square by R. These are the notations for power. Based on this formula only, maximum number of problems we can able to solve in this concept. Okay students, now we can go for problems one by one. See students, this is one simple problem we have. Just we can go through this problem. A 2 kilowatt heater, means here power is equal to 2 kilowatt is given. Okay, heater of capacity 10 liters is used for heating water. The time required to raise the temperature by 10 K is, that is expecting, means here condition is time required is equal to how much? Here volume is equal to 10 liters is given. So here one more condition here given as mass of 1 liter water is equal to 1 kg. Here volume 10 liters is given. So from that notation here one thing, 1 liter water value is 1 kg. Therefore 10 liter water value is becomes here 10 kg. Therefore I am imagine here M value is equal to 10 kg I am choosing in data. So next, specific heat of water is also given. Specific heat of water S value is equal to 4200 joule kg inverse, Kelvin inverse. This is the given data we have. So students, now we want to calculate here T value we want to calculate. So here rise in temperature delta T is also given as 10 K. For this thing, one thing once remember all of students, P value is equal to, we know basic thing, W by T. This is one standard formula. But instead of work done, we are taken as heat energy. So W is nothing but Q I am taken. That is P is equal to Q by T is also I am representing. Since here I am taking W value is equal to Q, I am represented here. Therefore, by heat concepts, Q value is equal to MS delta T divided by T. See, since I am representing Q is equal to MS delta T, this one in previous years in heat topics, you know very well based on the concept of specific heats. So we are identifying the things. Now, student, here observe carefully. Here 2 kilowatts is nothing but 2000 watts. So power value is, here directly substituting, 2000, mass is 10, specific heat of water is 4200, delta T, a rise in temperature is 10 is given. Here we want to calculate time, so T value we want to calculate. See students, here by simple thing, 1, 2, 3, 3 zeros cancel, 1, 2, 3, 3 zeros I am cancelled. This T here how many times cancelled? Here 21 times cancelled, here 1 time. So on cross multiplication, T value is equal to 10 into 21, nothing but 210 seconds. So this much time is required to heating that given mass of water. Okay students, further one more simple problem also. Now we will start it. See students, this is the second problem in your prescribed material. How the question is given is, a heater coil working on mains is cut into three equal parts and one part is only used. Means let I am taking, this is one wire maybe. This is having length L I am taken. Maybe I am taking this one is resistance R is present. So this is first case. Now this one is divided into how many parts? Three equal parts. 1, 2, 3. 3 parts is divided. So this is L by 3. This is L by 3. And this one is L by 3. Now for each part resistance is becomes R by 3, R by 3 and R by 3. So here initially here complete wire taken, here only one piece is we are choosing. So now let here R1 is I am taken as R, here only one piece is using, means I am taking R2 value is equal to R by 3. So the quantity of heat produced is in this condition we want to identify. See students, here for example, here Q1 is equal to Q I am taking, here Q2 value is equal to, we want to identify the things. See here students, P value is equal to, we know one notation, that is nothing but Q by T, and also we have V square divided by R. So now in this situation students, T is constant, V square is constant, this is a main supply is constant, therefore I am representing Q is inversely proportional to R. So once observe carefully, now Q1 divided by Q2 is equal to, we can written as R2 divided by R1. So Q1 is equal to, we are chosen as Q, and Q2 we want to calculate. R2 value is already from the above diagrams were identified R by 3, and this one is R. So this one is cancelled. Q2 is equal to, we got 3Q. So now from options, which one is suitable thing here? Here option 1, once observe carefully, 3 times the original heat. So therefore Q2 is equal to, we can represent here as 3 times the original value. 3 times the original value of heat we may represent. Means if suppose a given wire is cut into 3 equal parts, that one is only one part is continuously using, means okay, how much heat is generated? 3 times heat value is here increasing by maintaining same main voltage. Okay students, so one more problem, now we will go for that. This is also very very simple thing we have students, just observe carefully. Two heater wires of equal length. Equal length means, for example here, length constant. Length constant means compulsory, therefore resistance also constant. Resistance is constant. So I am taking like this. Therefore I am representing R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R. That is the thing. Connected in series and then in parallel. First in case 1, in series connected. In series connected means we may represent this one like this. For example, this is first resistance, this is second resistance, this is r and this one is r. So now in this situation rs value is equal to r plus r is equal to 2r when two resistors in which combination? Series combination. So now I am going for case 2. In case 2, the same resistors are connected in which combination? Parallel combination. So this is one parallel combination we are represented. So this is R and this one is also R. So now here effective resistance RB is equal to, now the thing is R into R divided by R plus R. So this is R square divided by 2R. So R divided by 2, like this we are getting. So in case of a parallel combination, effective resistance is R by 2 we are identifying. So now observe students clearly the ratio of heat produced in the two cases observing. So expecting that person is QS divided by Q parallel is equal to how much? So once observe clearly students, P value is equal to Q by T is equal to V square divided by R, we will represent it. So here in a situation this T and V square is constant. Now I am representing Q is inversely proportional to R. Therefore QS divided by QP is equal to RP divided by R, yes we can represent. So RP value is R by 2, this one is 2R. So we will get here as how much we are identifying here, this is R will be cancelled, 1 by 4 we will get. Therefore QS is to QP is equal to, we are getting as 1 is to 4, this is the notation we are getting. So this is the simple problem we are identified, the relation we are identified, the result also. So further we will go for one more problem students. This is the next problem students, just go through data first based on this given problem, later we will find the result. Okay, a electric water heater has a resistance of 12 ohms is given. So resistance R value is equal to 12 ohm is given and is operated from 220 volts. So V is equal to 220 volt power line. If no heat escapes from it, how much time is required? So here T is equal to how much to raise the temperature of 40 kg, means M value is equal to 40 kg is given of water from 16 degrees C to here 18 degrees C. Means for example T1 is equal to 16 degrees C, T2 value is equal to 18 degrees C. Therefore delta T value is equal to T2 minus T1 is equal to 18 degrees minus 16 degrees. So that's value is equal to 2 degrees C. So this is the actually data we are choosing. Now in this situation we want to find out here also T value, time value we want to find. So once recall the simple formula students, we know P is equal to Q by T, that is nothing but V square by R. So here instead of Q we can able to write here MS delta T divided by T is equal to V square by R. So just go through substitutions. Mass value 40 is given. Here water clearly mentioned. For water S value is equal to 4200 is the thing in SI unit. For water S is equal to 4200. So I am mentioning here that value is here 4200. Delta T value is 2 is given. We want to calculate time value here V square. V square is nothing but how much here students? 220 into 220 volt divided by R, that is 12 is present. So just I will try to simplify these notations clearly. This is 0, this 0, these two zeros cancelled. So one more thing is this 2 here 11 times cancelled, then here second table 20 times, second table here 11 times. So therefore T value is equal to, we can just rearrange as 12 into 20 into 42 divided by 11 into 11. So in numerator we are getting here as how much we are getting here, once observe carefully. This value students were getting as 10080 divided by, here 11 into 11 is nothing but 121. So on calculation we are getting t value is equal to 83.3 second is the thing. So answer is here 83.3 seconds, that much time is required for this thing. Okay students, this is the result. This is the simple problem students, just listen carefully. A 5 degree rise in temperature is observed in a conductor by passing a current. When the current is doubled, the rise in temperature will be approximately expected. So initially delta T1 is equal to 5 degrees C is given students. Expecting delta T2 is equal to how much? But current is increasing doubled. So let I1 is equal to I, I2 value is equal to 2I. So we have three formulas per power for those things. Just once we are recalled, means P is equal to, we know one thing is W by T or Q by T, and one more thing is V square by R, and one more thing is I square R is the one more formula we have. So in all these things, which one is related here? This one is, we can use it. So I am mentioning here, has P is equal to I square R, or nothing but here Q by T is equal to I square R, I will represent it. Just for continuation purpose, here instead of Q I am representing MS delta T. So by heat concepts we know that thing. So instead of that Q I am representing MS delta T by small t is equal to I square R. So here all the remaining factors is constants. M is constant, S is constant, small t is constant, and R is constant. So therefore I am rewriting this one as delta T is proportional to I square. So simple thing students, now observe delta T1 divided by delta T2 value is equal to I1 divided by I2 whole square, like that. So this is 5 degrees given, delta T2 value we want to find. This is I1 is I is given, and I2 value is 2I is given here whole square. So this one cancelled. So 5 divided by delta T2 is equal to 1 by 4 we are observed. Therefore delta T2 is equal to 4 into 5, that's value is equal to 20 degrees C. So approximately delta T2 value is equal to 20 degrees C. So this is the result for us. Okay students, this is the identified result. See students, this is the last and final problem here I am solving for you. So what is the way that question is represented here? Once we will check it. If in the circuit dissipation is 150 watts, then R is. So here expecting R value. R value is equal to how much? Power is equal to 150 watts is given students. So once observe carefully in this circuit, the thing is 2 ohms and R in parallel. Here 2 ohms and R are in parallel. So therefore we may get R effective is equal to 2 into R divided by 2 plus R. So that is the effective resistance we people know. So and also in diagram we are observing V value is equal to 15 volts. So once observe students, P is equal to V square by R general formula. So P is equal to V square divided by R effective I am representing here. So P value is equal to how much? 150 is equal to V value is 15. So 15 into 15 divided by, this is 2R divided by here 2 plus R. So for simple thing I am writing by cross multiplications, 2R divided by 2 plus R is equal to 15 into 15 divided by 150 I am representing students. So simple calculations, 15 here 10 times cancelled. So here 5th table 3 times, here 5th table 2 times. So we got here 2R divided by 2 plus R value is equal to 3 by 2. So just cross multiplication you can do. Okay, so this 2 into 2R is becomes 4R. 4R is equal to here 6 plus 3R we are identified. So therefore 4R minus 3R is equal to 6. therefore R is equal to 6 ohms. So in the given circuit, this R value we are calculated as 6 ohms. So answer is how much? 6 ohms is the answer. Okay students, almost all the problems, all the different models in current electricity we are completed. So in next class we are ready to starting a new chapter, that is magnetism and matter. Okay, in next class we will start new chapter, magnetism and matter. So thank you.